dig it. Man, oh man, the time has actually come. Of course, I get tons and tons of emails and requests for tunes that I've actually written and some original material in terms of what we would call modern jazz. Now, of course, the era of modern jazz and the way I see it really kind of started with the hard bop era and went into the 60s. That's really kind of when you look at the harmonic detail or the modern harmony of jazz. That's really what I would think of it that way. Of course, this particular tune that I wrote is called Twist. And the thing I really liked about this tune when it came out is the fact that I really was focusing or hearing a Lydian sound. Now, when I say came out, I really mean that I kind of hear the melody first. A lot of times the tunes that I write, this melody is really kind of focused on a minor pentatonic pattern that really comes a half step down from what we would call a C Lydian chord or C with a sharp 11. And the thing I love about that particular sound, it has this really major, kind of minor, kind of in-between sound. It's a sound you'll hear in pop music and you hear it in jazz. Now, not that much in the bebop era. You would hear it a little bit, mostly the sharp 11 over the dominant chord. Of course, the song that really comes to mind when I think of sharp 11 dominant is Blue Train by John Coltrane. In this particular tune, I'm using the major and I'm kind of taking a slant or really influenced by You Stepped Out of a Dream in terms of thinking about this tune. I must have listened to that song a lot when I wrote this. And really, the chord changes are easy. I will, in fact, have a backing track for this particular tune if you want to play along with it. There is a drum part, and you can actually play along and explore with this tune. It's really not that complex. What I'm really thinking about is thinking as both chords, the C major 7 sharp 11 or the C sharp major sharp 11. I'm thinking of them as the four chord of G and G sharp. That's kind of how you get that sound. You don't have to overcomplicate it. So you're really thinking of playing the one chord off the four or the four chord off the one, depending on how you want to think about it. And that is really where I'm at with that. So what am I doing? Well, I'm basically focusing on playing G major and G sharp major or A flat major, depending on how you want to look at it. And that's really how I'm getting that Lydian sound, and it really offers a great way to kind of expand that. I'm thinking of this as a modal tune, which is one way that I like to write and one way I really like to play. The other thing you can do harmonically is what the melody is really doing here at the beginning is playing minor pentatonic a half step down. So you're really kind of thinking of the three chord in the major key. So in this particular case, I would be thinking of the three chord as B minor. So B minor pentatonic would work over that first chord or C major 7 because it's a half step down. And then I just modulated a half step up. So now I'm thinking of C minor pentatonic over the C sharp. That's another great way to get some really interesting tones off of those particular chords and getting that Lydian sound if you really dig it. Now, if you dig this video, make sure to check out my video on So What and all the other videos on the BHX.TV site. Of course, the channel does release new videos on Tuesdays and on Fridays. And don't forget to check out the new series on Wednesdays, Jazz Standards You Need to Know. And I will see you next time. Peace. Thank you.
Thank you.